Salam, my good people. I'm just sitting here reading this article on KIK Knowledge is King. The name of the article is African American Distract, Divide and Conquer by Malik Green. Interesting piece, let me share it with you. As I look at the current state of Black America, the most significant issue today regarding African Americans is a lack of unity. This lack of unity has contributed to our inability to progress politically, socially and economically as a race in America. No can deny that there is a shortage of unity in the Black community. The question to ask is why? As I asked this question, my thoughts went to something that I wrote about in my book, The Black Print. In one of the chapters of the book, I wrote about the slave trade and the role that Africans played in the enslavement of Africans by the Europeans. The role Africans played in the slave trade is an important question that needed to be answered. Why is this important question? Because white folk love to bring up the fact that Africans sold other Africans into slavery whenever the subject of slavery is brought up. While doing my research on the subject of slavery, I discovered a letter from an African king to the king of Portugal during the height of the slave trade. This letter gave tremendous insight about how and why other Africans sold their brethren to the European slave traders. What does this have to do with the current state of Black America and subduing the Black race? Well, after you read this letter from the African leader to the King of Portugal, you will see the relevance. The following letter was published in a book written by Adam Hirschfeld, King Leopold's Ghost, A Story of Greed, Terror and Heroism in Colonial Africa. The letter states the misgivings the African king had regarding the slave trade in his country. Each day the traders are kidnapping our people, children of this country, sons of our nobles and vassals, even people of our own family. This corruption and depravity are so widespread that our land is entirely depopulated. We need in this kingdom only priests and school teachers, and no merchandise, unless it is wine and flour for mass. It is our wish that this kingdom not be a place for the trade or transport of slaves. Many of our subjects eagerly lust after Portuguese merchandise that your subjects have brought into our domains. To satisfy this inordinate appetite, they seize many of our Black free subjects. They sell them. After having taken these prisoners to the coast, secretly or at night. As soon as the captives are in the hands of white men, they are branded with a red hot iron. As you can see from this letter, the European strategy to conquer the Black race was to distract, divide and conquer. The distraction came by way of the introduction of material goods, liquor, food, guns, etc., that appeal to the base nature of human beings. This desire for individual pleasure led to a division among the tribal community. This division among the tribe made the task of conquering the Black race quite easy. Over the last three decades, the strategy of distract, divide and conquer has re-emerged and is being used quite effectively today to subdue the Black race again. Allow me to elaborate. African Americans today have bought into the concept of materialism and individualism. Establishing unity among African Americans today is a very difficult task. We are all so caught up in our own personal quest for fame and fortune that the word unity is foreign to us. The inundation of images of famous and wealthy Black people living large promotes individualism and selfishness. The desire for personal fame and fortune distracts and divides many of us from the important issues affecting all African Americans. Issues such as high incarceration rates, high unemployment, and crime-ridden communities. So, while a few African Americans, approximately 8, have a high standard of living, the majority of us still suffer from oppressive and disenfranchising elements in American society. The Black elite, African American entertainers, athletes, entrepreneurs and politicians are experiencing and enjoying all that America has to offer. The problem with this is that it is happening at the expense of less fortunate African Americans. The Black elite may continue to enjoy life in America so long as they operate from an individualistic point of view. Basically, sell out the rest of your people and you will enjoy the abundance of America. However, if you promote unity among your black people in American, you will lose your privileges. In summary, a unified black America may never be realized if we continue to allow the strategy of distract, divide and conquer to permeate the minds and hearts of African Americans. There is an old saying, fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on me. Come on, black America, wake up to the game. There is enough wealth in America for all of us. We don't have to step on one another to get ahead. We can do it together as African Americans. That's the end of the article. I lend this with a surah from the Quran. The verse is Surat Ar-Ra'd, the thunder. It reads, for each one are successive angels before and behind him who protect him by the decree of Allah. Indeed, Allah will not change the condition of a people until they change what is in themselves. And when Allah intends for a people ill, there is no repelling it. And there is not for them besides him any patron. To read this article for yourself, go to KIK Knowledge is King. Search KIK Knowledge is King and it should be at the top of the search page. Peace.